Now that she was earning a good income in personal sales, my mother began to build a sales organization that operated throughout the state of Michigan under the trade name of Liberty Registered Company. Mother and I would see each other on holidays and during vacation periods. My second high school summer vacation was spent in Detroit. That's when I, too, learned to sell accident insurance, and that's when I started to search for a sales system for myself, a system that would never fail. The Liberty Registry Company office was in the old Free Press building. I spent a day in the office reading and studying the policy I was to try to sell the next day. My sales instructions were as follows. 1. Completely canvass the Dime Bank building. 2. Start at the top floor and call on each and every office. 3. Avoid calling in the office of the building. 4. Use the introduction. May I take a moment of your time? 5. Try to sell everyone you call on. So I followed instructions. The first day I sold 2 policies, 2 more than I'd ever sold before. The second day, 4, and that was a 100% increase. The third day, 6, a 50% increase. And the fourth day, I learned an important lesson. I called at a large real estate office, and when I stood at the desk of the sales manager and used the introduction, "May I take a moment of your time?" I was startled, for he jumped to his feet, pounded his desk with his right fist, and almost shouted, "Boy, as long as you live, never ask a man for his time. Take it." So I took his time and sold him and 26 of his salesmen that day. That started me thinking, there must be a scientific way to sell many policies every day. I reasoned, success can be reduced to a formula, and failure can be reduced to a formula. Apply the one and avoid the other. Think for yourself. Regardless of who you are, it is desirable to learn the techniques of good salesmanship. For selling is merely persuading another person to accept your service, your product, or your idea. In a sense, everyone is a salesman. Whether or not you are a salesman by vocation, the minute details of my selling system are not really important to you, but the principles may be, if you are ready. What is important to you is that you reduce to a formula, preferably in writing, the principles you learn from your successful experiences and your failures in whatever activities you may be interested. But you may not know how to extract principles from what you read, hear, or experience. I'll illustrate how I did it. But you must think for yourself. Although I called in each office in sequence in the Dime Bank building, I had not licked the fear of opening a door, particularly when I couldn't see what was on the other side. Many of the glass doors were frosted or had curtains on the inside. It was necessary to develop a method of forcing myself to enter. Then, because I searched, I found the answer. I reasoned, success is achieved by those who try. Where there's nothing to lose by trying, and a great deal to gain if successful, by all means try. The repetition of either of these self-motivators satisfied my reason. But I was still afraid, and it was still necessary to get into action. Fortunately, I struck upon the self-starter. Do it now. Because I'd learned the value of trying to establish the right habits and the harm of acquiring wrong habits, it occurred to me that I could force myself to action as I left one office if I would rush quickly into the next one. Should it occur to me to hesitate, I would use the self-starter, do it now, and immediately act on it. This I did. When once inside a place of business, I was still not at ease, but I soon learned how to neutralize the fear of talking to a stranger. I did it through voice control. I found that if I spoke loudly and rapidly, hesitated where there would be a period, comma, or other punctuation if the spoken word were in writing, kept a smile in my voice, and used modulation, I no longer had butterflies in my stomach. Later I learned that this technique was based on a very sound psychological principle. The emotions, like fear, are not always immediately subject to reason, but they are always subject to action. When thoughts do not neutralize an undesirable emotion, action will. The sales manager in the real estate office hadn't liked the introduction. May I take a moment of your time? Besides, many persons on whom I had used this introduction had answered no. So I abandoned it. And after experimenting, came up with a new one that I've used ever since. I believe this will interest you also. No one has ever said no to this introduction. Many have asked, what is it? Then, of course, I've told them and given them my sales talk. The purpose of a sales introduction is solely to get a person to listen. Know when to quit. Try to sell everyone you call on was one of the instructions my mother had given me. So I stayed with every prospect. Sometimes I wore him out. But when I left his place of business, I was worn out too. It seemed to me that in selling a low-cost service as I was doing, it was imperative that I average more sales per hour of effort. For it wasn't every day that I sold 27 policies in one place of business. So I decided not to sell everyone I called on, if the sale would take longer than a time limit I had set for myself. I'd try to make the prospect happy and leave hurriedly, even though I knew that if I stayed with him, I could make the sale. Wonderful things happened. I increased my average number of sales per day tremendously. What's more, the prospect, in several instances, thought I was going to argue. But when I left him so pleasantly, he would come next door to where I was selling and say, "You can't do that to me." Every other insurance man would hang on. "You come back and write it." Instead of being tired out after an attempted sale, I experienced enthusiasm and energy from my presentation to the next prospect. The principles I learned are simple. Fatigue is not conducive to doing your best work. Don't reduce your energy level so low that you drain your battery. The activity level of the nervous system is raised when the body recharges itself with rest. Time is one of the most important ingredients in any successful formula for any human activity. Save time. Invest it wisely. When you are talking to a person, look at his eyes, I was taught as a youngster. But in selling, I would look at a person's eyes, and he would often shake his head no. And more often, he would interrupt me. I didn't like this. It slowed me down. Soon, I hit on a simple technique to avoid this. Get the prospect to concentrate through his senses of sight and hearing on what I had to show him and on what I had to say. I pointed to the policy or sales literature and looked at it as I gave my sales talk. Because I looked where I was pointing, he looked too. If out of the corner of my eye, I saw a prospect shake his head no, I paid no attention. Often, he would become interested, and I would later close the sale.